Will you welcome these guys to the stage right now? You guys come on up here if you would, and we'll have a good time. Give them a hand if you would. Y'all say hi to Mr. Tim Nichols right here, ladies and gentlemen. Mo Pitney right here. And y'all say hi to two of our Chattanooga boys. These are local boys. They've done good up there in Nashville. Y'all say hi to Kelley Lovelace. And also from Chattanooga, and if you haven't seen Mitch, you're going to love him now. He will set you on fire, that's for sure. Will you give him a big hand, Mr. Mitch Roselle? Kelley, you guys enjoy.
Thank you, Ken. Thank you, US 101. Thank you, Bethel. Putting together this beautiful room. Does it not look amazing in here? Looks amazing. You know, it was several years ago. I forget how many years we've done this now, but I always need to give a shout out to Pat Boone for 35 years. You know, he was entertaining people and just giving his heart and his time and his money and his efforts and his prayers to Bethel, and he's still doing that. And when they asked me to kind of fill in if he stepped down, I said, would you do that? And I said, well, that's a huge reduction in celebrity. I said, I'll do it until we find somebody. But they hadn't found anybody yet, so that's why I'm still here. But I brought some friends of mine, and we're basically writers, but we are artists. At least two of us are. And so we're going to play a game tonight called Two of These Things Don't Belong Here. And they're going to pass out a piece of paper each one individually. I think there's 850 people here. Nancy, if you get that started right now, just little sheets of paper. And you'll figure out who the two artists are. So it's going to take some time, I guarantee it. It may take you all night, and we'll have something for the winner, but we're not sure what that is yet. But did anybody see Mitch Roselle at the Tivoli Theater a few weeks back ago? Maybe a month, something like that. So he did such a great job, and you know, we brought him there so that he could entertain people, but not really, you know, like steal the show. And so, which he kind of did. And you're wondering, yeah, why did you invite him to this? And well, it's a great question, but we've talked about it backstage. He said he's going to kind of keep it here and not give all, you know, so that when it's my turn, it still sounds really great. So give a huge round of applause for Mitch Roselle, local boy here in Chattanooga, doing great. We're glad to have him. And we're going to do, a lot of you folks have seen a writer's round, you know, so we're gonna play things that we've written either with each other. Hopefully you've heard some of these things, and as songwriters, which we all are, you know, we do, what that means is we get up about, you know, 10, get to the music row, at least by 10:30, 11 o'clock, get something started. If we do come up with an idea, then we're pretty pleased with that, and we're also hungry, because it takes a lot of, you know, energy to really get those ideas. So we go and we eat, and it's usually Mexican, which is a little heavy, so we're a little sleepy afterwards, so we go home about 3. But we reschedule, and a couple weeks later, then we actually kind of finish something. But when we're in there, the songs that we're going to be playing you, hopefully they come from emotion. They come from a place that somebody's, you know, somebody's hurting or somebody's happy. And we come into the co-writer room, and we're almost praying that somebody's going through something, hopefully good, but it could be tragic, you know. And so you come in and somebody says, how you doing? I said, well, not really good. No, really? Says, yeah, I'm kind of going through a divorce. I said, great. I mean, not great. Tell me about that. And then he starts talking about it and saying, yeah, go on. Uh-huh. All right. How's it make you feel? And so you're writing things down. And so anyway, but by the end of it, you know, you got a guy who's kind of crying and you think, hey, I know you're real upset right now, but you said something kind of that could be a funny song. I think we could actually make some money off that. And he said, really, you think so? And I said, yeah, it goes like this. So anyway, all right, give Mitch Roselle a big round of applause. Let's get this thing started. We're going to have fun, and we'll be up here for a good bit.
All right, thank you, Kelley. Glad to be here tonight. Everybody good? All right, all 7 of you good. Everybody good? All right, it's a little better. I'm excited to be here. How many of y'all like a good breakup song? Yeah? This is not that. I wrote this song with my favorite co-writer in town, myself.
Thank you. Oh.
Well, I've never seen Venice or slow danced under Paris lights. Never stood by the pyramids or hiked up the Great Divide. Well, I've never been to Times Square to celebrate the New Year and I've never seen Willie Nelson live. And if I never get to, that's alright. 'Cause I've seen you with your hair down and your bare feet, dancing around the living room, spilling wine on your dress. And I've seen you on a bench seat in a tank top and your blue jeans, getting your lipstick on my neck. So if all I do is live in this small town with you and never leave, I've seen all I need to see. Ooh. Well, I've never seen Ireland and those green hills that roll for miles, but my guess is that they ain't got nothing on your green eyes. And I've never seen Niagara Falls or stood inside the prison walls where Cash recorded life. Well, some may say I'm missing out, but that's a lie. 'Cause I've seen you and your songs on and you're singing words that are all wrong, and you swear to me that that's how it goes. And I've seen you when tears fall, 'cause the episode that you just saw felt like more than just a show. So if all I do is live in this small town with you and never leave, I've seen all I need to see. I've seen you with your hair down and your bare feet, dancing around the living room, spilling wine on your dress. And I've seen you on a bench seat in a tank top and your blue jeans, getting your lipstick on my neck. So if all I do is live in this small town with you and never leave, yeah, that'd be fine with me, 'cause I've seen all I need to see.
Mitch Rosell.
Thank you.
That's starting out strong. That's strong like bull. Noticed your mic sounds great. It was a little better.
You got my auto-tune turned on back.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
Yeah, absolutely. No, that's great. I do love that song. That's the second or third time I've heard it. I love it each time more a little bit. All right, so I'll play you something. This... a lot of you know, so I don't like to tell the same thing over and over again, but went to Belmont a long time ago, as Mitch was reminding me, a long time ago, and I met Brad Paisley there. We got to be friends and neighbors, and we still live on the same farm today. And so I was, you know, in the business world, you'd say he's my biggest account. So that makes sense, right? So you always want to be good to your biggest accounts. And so I was out on the road with him, and I was overhearing him talk about a Foo Fighters record called Wasting Light. And as an idea guy, I thought, man, Wasting Light, what a cool thought, you know. And then he went on to say, yeah, it's not even a song, it's just the name of their record. And I went, that's even more interesting. And so I started thinking about that, and I thought, well, how could I countryfy that and kind of put a Hot Daisy Duke lookalike, you know, on the riverbank, dancing to some Luke Bryan song and make some money and stay in my house for another year. That's what I was kind of thinking. But so I came up with an idea called Running Out of Moonlight, and which I really like the idea. And, you know, and again, sometimes ideas, it's not, you know, it's not rocket surgery. You got to think about it for a second. So you got, come on, boys, we're running out of daylight. Back in the old West, come on, girl, running out of moonlight. It's not that difficult sometimes. but anyway, so I thought about it. I had had a good co-write the next day, and I was talking. It was Ashley Gorley and Dallas Davis, and two good buddies and two great writers. And if you have the right idea with that combo, it's going to come out pretty good. But I needed to call Brad and ethically make sure that was kind of okay, because I was out on his bus eating his catering. So it was only fair that I pitch it to him first. And so I called him and I said, hey, here's where I got the idea. I really love it. I think it's a hit. I said, if you want me to save it, I'll wait till you start writing again. But if not, if you don't love it, I said, I wouldn't mind writing it tomorrow. And he said, "Running out of moonlight, huh?" I said, "Yeah." And he goes, and this is just classic writer, artist fashion. We always want to change something, you know. He goes, "What if it's running out of moonshine instead?" And now you have to encourage them, okay? I said, "That's good. That's good. It's good. I like that. I like that a lot." Because you don't want to say, like, "No, I don't like that." And then they shut down, then they hang up, and then it takes a couple months to get another writing appointment with them. So first off, I said, "I love that." I said, "Almost better, but not 100%. I said, "I really like it the way it is." I said, "If you wouldn't mind, I wouldn't mind writing that tomorrow, you know?" And he goes, "You know what? It's a while before I'm writing anyway, so go ahead." So we did, worked out really well, and a couple weeks later, Randy Houser recorded it, and I think it was his second number one, and it was one of the most played songs in 2014, which I know is a long time ago, but I mentioned. I would make him whole step down if you want to play.
Don't you worry about getting fixed up when you wake up. You're pretty enough. Look out your window at the cloud of dust. That's my headlights and that's my truck. Come on, girl, don't you keep me waiting. Gotta go, I got a reservation. Tailgate for two underneath the stars. Kiss on your lips when you're in my arms. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Every now and then you get a night like this. Whoa, whoa, whoa. This is one that you don't want to miss, no. Come on, baby, let me take you on a night ride. Windows down, sitting by my side. Tick-tock, now we're knocking on midnight. Me and you, girl, running out of moonlight. Want to hold you to the break of dawn. Hear the crickets singing riverside love song. Hey, baby, all we got is all night. Come on now, we're running out of moonlight. Girl, I bet you thought I lost my mind. Out of the blue, pulling up in your drive. Wonder why I got your way out here. Have you ever seen a sky this clear? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, you've never looked better than you do right now. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Heaven let your light shine down. Come on, baby, let me take you on a night ride. Wind is down, sitting by my side. Tick-tock, now we're knocking on midnight. Me and you, girl. Running out of moonlight. Wanna hold you to the break of dawn. Hear the crickets singing riverside love song. Hey baby, all we got is all night. Come on now, we're running out of moonlight.
I'll give you some love.
You don't want to miss, no. Come on, baby, let me take you on a night ride. Wind is down, sitting by my side. Tick-tock, now we're knocking on midnight. Me and you, girl, we're running out of moonlight. Want to hold you to the break of dawn. Hear the crickets singing riverside love song. Hey, baby, all we got is all night. Come on now, we're running out of moonlight. All I want to do is hold you tight. Now come on, come on now, we're running out of moonlight. Oh, baby, don't I feel so right? Now come on, come on now, we're running out of moonlight.
Kelley Lovelace.
Thank you. Thank you, Mo, for playing that with me. Thank you, guys. All right, up next, we have a huge treat even for myself because I actually just met Mo today. I've heard of his music and everything, but I've never seen him play live. So this is going to be, hopefully good. I mean, is it? I don't know. I know it's going to be great. Give him a lot of love. Come on, welcome here.
I'm known for letting down, I'll tell you. This is a song I actually got to write with Tim.
All right,
Jimmy. And he didn't know this until right now, but I think we're going to record it on Monday. You wouldn't mind, would you?
This night, what a wonderful night this is, huh?
This is great.
Got a closet full of brand new jeans that just don't feel as good to me as this wholly worn out pair that I've got on. And I could buy a brand new truck, but there's something about dancing rust that won't let a guy forget where he came from. Yeah, a new ride would have brand new leather, but I like the old stuff better. There's something about an old time town, an old cafe, an old courthouse, that makes me want to stop and buy a Coke. I love old songs, old guitars, jukebox, old country stars, and scratchy 45s popping those. Hey, I like CDs too. For the record, I like the old stuff better. Must be where I came from, 'cause it's always where I go. Yeah, I know I was born with an old soul. Hey, I like things with history and a story to be told. I guess that's just the way I'm put together. I like the old stuff better. Hey, I'm not knocking progress. I'm glad we're gaining ground. But sometimes I just wish we could slow down. That's why I love when Mama writes me, 'cause she puts paper to pen. Yeah, I've got that drawer where I keep all her letters. Even I'll admit, Facebook's pretty clever, but I like the old stuff. I like the old stuff better.
Wow.
Wow.
That's amazing. That is real country music.
Woo!
And what a great voice. Good grief.
Man, oh man, you see me smiling? You see this smile? And you did you hear that? The magic when you take a great voice and couple it with a great song.
Yeah, man. You done did it, too.
That you wrote.
I think that was your
that
idea.
That I wrote. That's right. That's what I'm saying. No. How about a hand for Mo Pitney? That's awesome. Man, oh man. That's good. That's real good. Hey, so I'm curious. We were backstage. I didn't get to see. How many people? Is anybody? This is your first time here this evening. Anybody? Well, there's a few of you. Well, that's good. Okay, listen. Yes, right, right. So listen, for those of you that haven't been to this event before, as you see, we're all songwriters, and so we wrote all these songs, and so. The whole idea here is by the time we finish this evening, we want you all to feel like you know songwriters a little better. For example, do you all know the difference between a songwriter and a large pizza? Well, a large pizza can feed a family of four. That's right. That's right. Behind every successful songwriter, there's a very shocked mother-in-law. I know firsthand, I will tell you. And then also people, they ask us, they want to know, well, where do song ideas come from? And this first song that I'll do this evening, it came from an audiobook. The idea for the song came from an audiobook, and I will tell you, it was not a good audiobook. Bad, it was a bad book.
But I kept hoping that it would get better, so I kept listening. And thankfully, this one particular day, it got better. And so what was happening in the book this particular day, the main character in the book, his name was Texas Jack Carmine. If I'd paid more attention, I guess, to this main character's name, it should have been a clue that the book's not going to be very good. Texas Jack, of course I understand that. He's a Texas Jack, he's like a cowboy guy, except his last name was Carmine. So I don't know if he was like an Italian cowboy, which seems, not right. One of these things is not like the other, which, speaking of like one of these things not being like the other, I didn't know if I needed. Does anybody have a black hat? I don't have my black hat. Yeah, I mean, anyway. But anyway, enough.
I digress.
I digress. So anyway, on this particular day of listening, things are not going well for Texas Jack in Texas. And so, therefore, Texas Jack decides he needs to get out of Texas. And the way he's going to decide where to go was, he was going to flip a coin. Heads, he was going to go to California. Tails, he was going to go to Mexico. That's when the song got good. That's when the idea got good. That's when the book got good. That's what I'm trying to say. That's when the book got good, because I heard an idea in there that I believed I could turn into a song. And I believed I could take that song and turn it into commerce. Yeah, I can see we all understand commerce, yes. So at that time, Jody Messina was a brand new artist working on her very first record. And at that time, Jody Messina lived about 5 minutes from me in a little town called Mount Juliet, Tennessee, about just a few minutes east of Nashville. So I put this song in Jody Messina's mailbox. Several months later, Jody Messina puts a big fat check in my mailbox. It was beautiful. And I will tell you, I've put many, many songs in Jody Messina's mailbox since then. No big fat check. But this first time.
Hey, baby, what do you say we just get lost?
Okay, I appreciate that. That one, just a smattering of applause met by a big fat round of indifference, seemed like. Listen, I got to tell you all, I do lots of shows like this, and I do a lot of fair amount of shows with Kelley, and so he can tell you, too, that without fail, I mean, other than just right then, after I sing that first line, audiences always break into thunderous applause.
It's true.
It's just what happens. And so when it didn't happen just then, it threw me off because for a millisecond, I knew something wasn't right. And then it hit me, well, there's total silence. Except for that one guy that said, yeah.
He did say, yeah. And I apologize because this is a little embarrassing for me because I've brought Tim here and this is my hometown and this is the first time this ever happened.
Yeah. But listen, I feel like you're a very sharp group. I mean, you're certainly a good looking group. And I feel like you're a sharp group and you catch on quickly, which is why I'm going to give you another opportunity here. That's right.
Yes.
To help me feel really good, not only about myself, but my life's work.
Hey, baby, what do you say we just get along? That's more like it.
There it is.
Leave this one-horse town like two rebels without a cause. I've got people in Boston, ain't your daddy still in Des Moines? We can pack up tomorrow, tonight, let's flip a coin. Oh, heads, Carolina, tails, California, somewhere greener, somewhere warmer, up in the mountains, down by the ocean where it don't matter, long as we're going somewhere together. I've got a quarter, heads, Carolina, tails, California, yep. Yeah. We can load what we own in the back of a U-Haul van. Couple modern day Moses searching for the promised land. We can go 400 miles before we stop for gas. We can drive for a day, then we'll take a look at the map. Oh, heads Carolina, tails California, somewhere greener, somewhere warmer, up in the mountains, down by the ocean, where it don't matter, long as we're going somewhere together. I've got a quarter, heads Carolina, tails California, yeah. Yeah, Mo. Hey, we're gonna get out of here if we've got to ride a Greyhound bus. Girl, we're bound to outrun this bad luck that's tailing us. Heads Carolina, tails California, somewhere greener, somewhere warmer, up in the mountains, down by the ocean, where it don't matter, long as we're going somewhere together. I've got a quarter, heads Carolina, tails California. Woo. Carolina.
I see y'all singing along.
California. Oh, yeah.
Tim Nichols.
Thank y'all so much.
Awesome.
Sharp group, Kelley. Very sharp.
Very sharp. Sharp I told you.
Quick studies. Yes. Well done, people. Well done.
Good stuff. So I moved to Nashville a little over 8 years ago. And when I moved to Nashville, Mo and I were talking about this in the back. It was a time when the direction of the music was kind of going in a new way, and we won't get into the details of what that is, but it wasn't what I was doing. I'll just leave it at that. And it's really tough when you go to try to be successful at something, and you're just kind of having a hard time breaking through that wall. But I had a choice. I could either kind of chase that whole thing, or I could just kind of keep doing what I believed in, what I was feeling, and I say all that just to say, always be yourself. Always be yourself, because it'll always work out. And so fast forward to 2014, I had a chance to send my favorite artist of all time, Mr. Garth Brooks, some songs. And I still don't really understand exactly what he heard that separated me, but he really latched on to what I was doing and just started talking to me in SparkNotes version. We just started hanging out and getting to know each other and writing a little bit. And the next thing I know, I'd written a song. I write by myself a lot. I'm the weird guy in Nashville. I don't really have any friends, so I just write by myself a lot. So I had written a song on a Saturday, and I was in the process of trying to gather songs for my EP. Garth was going to, I was going to record it in the studio where he recorded all his records, and Don Williams recorded. I'm a huge Don Williams fan, so it was really special opportunity for me, and so I was trying to gather those songs, and I had just written this song, and I sent him a group of songs with this song in it. And next thing I know, he was calling me over to the house, and I went over there, and he kept talking to me like he wanted to cut something, but he didn't just say it, you know. And finally, I just came out and said, "Man, are there one of these songs that you want to cut?" And he goes, "Yeah, actually, there is." And I knew immediately which one it was, and very surreal. I never thought that my musical hero would ever even hear me, nonetheless, cut a song that I wrote. But he cut this song, and it was on his last record, and it was singled and went to number one in December. And pretty surreal, yeah. So if you know it, I hope you sing along with me here. Stubborn as they come, you'll never settle down. You'll always be the one
who doesn't stick around. You make all the rules, you're set in your ways. You gotta have your freedom, and you gotta have your space. But one day you'll meet the girl you swore you'd never find. Start feeling things you never felt, and spending all your time trying to figure out how she got this hold on you. And when you start to fall, you'll hold on to your pride. Start building up your walls and never let her get inside. And you'll push her away, cause that's all you know how to do. And then she'll leave, and you won't beg her not to go. Ask me how I know.
Yeah, thank you.
I won't shake your head. Tell me that I'm wrong. Say I'm just another fool, and this is just another song. But I know how you are, cause I know how I am. And I'd give anything to go back and try again. Cause one day you'll meet the girl you swore you'd never find. Start feeling things you never felt, spending all your time trying to figure out how she got this hold on you. And when you start to fall, you'll hold on to your pride. Start building up your walls and never let her get inside. And you'll push her away, cause that's all you know how to do. And then she'll leave, and you won't beg her not to go. Ask me how I. Help me out. Cause one day you'll meet the girl you swore you'd never find. Start feeling things you never felt, spending all your time trying to figure out how she got this hold on you. And when you start to fall, you'll hold on to your pride. Start building up your walls and never let her get inside. You'll push her away, cause that's all you know how to do. Ask me how I know, cause man, I know.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
Woo. Wow.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Appreciate that.
Wow.
Thank you, guys.
So how you guys doing on trying to figure out who the artists are up here? Y'all doing good with it? I don't know if they got all those papers passed out. That's amazing. I mean, sings great, writes great, and so we're 50. We got 50. Is that is that where we are in text to give? $50. Okay. How many people have a cell phone in here? $50. Come on, let's get that going. Nice job letting us know. I like that hat too. That's good. Give him a round of applause. Everybody deserves it. But just to, you know, I've never had a song recorded that I've written by myself. It just, what a huge thing it is. Not only to have a number one is ridiculous and amazing. In fact, you write it by yourself. I mean, that just doesn't happen, right? I mean, hardly ever. That's amazing.
I wish I could take the credit, but grace of God for sure on that.
Yes, absolutely. I thought you might play that, so I felt we needed like a palate cleanser, like some sorbet at a hibachi restaurant, so that you'd maybe get that out of your head for a second. And I'm going to get my wife to come up here. Her name's Karen, and you'll hear from her just in a little bit, and I'm going to ask her to sing something with me. And I mean, she has a great heart, and I'm gone a lot, and she supports this ministry by a lot of prayer and letting me do a lot of things. And being with the kids as well, she brought the horses a couple of years ago, and the kids got to ride horses, and we trailered them things up here, which realized it might be a little less trouble to just rent the horses local. But that truck moves a lot when that trailer's back there with the big horses. But But anyway, but she runs Airbnbs. You know, she loves that. She's done a lot of different things. And but she's very strict. She's got the house rules. You guys Airbnb people, you know about that, right? VRBO, Airbnb? Kind of. Because I'm not going to play this. If there's only three of you know, it's going to sound terrible. But Mitch, can you just kind of, do you mind holding that after?
It's going to cost you, but.
I know. Here it is. This is how we keep people humble. You go from a standing ovation and number one song you wrote by yourself to, hey, sir, could you please hold this for me? My
standing ovation to so, music stand.
So is Karen on her way up here? My wife, is she here? She didn't come to many of my shows, but
yeah,
hopefully she's here.
She's not coming to your show, buddy. I told you that earlier.
Okay, she's coming. Here we go. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about my wife. I'm going to tell you a little bit about her. She used to sell urban radio in Music City. It was little more Kanye than Conway Twitty. So she went on TV, that beautiful smile, selling solar lights like they were going out of style. But she found her calling, she found her niche, and gotta write these songs. Girl, we're gonna be rich. Cause now she's setting up a house for the bachelorettes. No smoking, no parties, and no pets. No feminine products down the toilet, please. Just a few house rules from the Airbnb queen. Now every day money's rolling our PayPal account, but she's complaining cause they're running all her white towels. She said they're getting makeup on everything and their hair's clogging up all the bathroom drains. I got a empathetic ear while I'm out on the course. I say, boys, she's gonna be late. Got time for nine more? Cause she's setting up the house for the bachelorettes. No smoking, no parties, and no pets. No feminine products down the toilet, please. Just a few house rules from the Airbnb queen. Yeah, I'm so dang proud of my Airbnb queen. There she is, come on. All right, so you want to stand or sit? What would you like to do?
I can't believe you did that. When did you write that?
I wrote it on the way up here. I did. It was raining. There's a lot of traffic, and so I just started thinking about what I was going to say tonight.
I feel like I'm a constable now. I'm really not that bad, y'all. Really not.
All right. Well, I'm glad to have Karen up here. We're going to do a song. This is actually, and Mitch, thank you very much. You're a good support for helping me do that. My first number one was a good while ago, and Mitch reminded me exactly how long ago it was. I didn't know it was as long as it was until he said, but anyway, the reason Karen's up here, besides the fact that she's great eye candy and a nice outfit, you look beautiful.
Well, thank you. It's not new. You'd be glad to know that. I've had it 2 or 3 years.
I don't have my contacts in,
okay.
So.
Okay, it's good. Okay. That's good. Ladies, that's good. As we get older, you don't want them to be able to see.
So anyway, this song is about me being a stepdad. And when Karen and I started dating, she had a 3-year-old son. His name was McCain, and he's 27 now. 27.
Yes.
But anyway, the hardest thing was you know, thinking about, you know, being a stepdad. And when I think about Bethel, and you think about the house parents and the ministry that Bethel is to these kids that are not necessarily their own. But they love them, you know, just like a parent would. They love them like God hopefully wants you to. And sometimes family situations are just not, you know, they're just not perfect. You know, this isn't heaven, and life isn't perfect. But you do have a lot of people with really good hearts within house parents. And being at Bethel a couple times and seeing the house parents and seeing the kids and seeing what they do makes me feel really, really insignificant because of the ministry that they're doing, you know. So. I just think they're great. And so the reason we thought about doing this song is about a stepdad is because of that. At least we can kind of feel a little bit of that. And we did this, and Tim reminded me, we did this at for a St. Jude benefit in Palm Desert. And Karen got up to do this and thought it'd be cool because me and Brad Paisley, before he was married, he came over and he ate dinner because my wife is country and she cooks really good. And he was single, and afterwards we went out on the porch, and there was a guitar staged out there. I mean, not staged, setting. It's always out there. And so anyway, he picked up the guitar and he started talking about my relationship with Karen and McCain. And he said, "Hey, you really love that little guy, don't you?" And I said, "Yeah." So he said, "You know, I thought that was going to be, you know, the hardest part, but all you got to really know how to do is play Nintendo games, you know, and you're a hero. And Nintendo would also let you know how old we are, probably." But anyway, so he said, "Well, you know, we ought to write a song to make Karen cry." And so that's what we set out to do when we wrote this song. And
well, he didn't think I ever cried. I mean, when Kelley and I used to go to the movies, he was the crier. He's still tenderhearted. And I was sort of like, yeah, just took a lot to make me cry.
And she's like a female Clint Eastwood, you know? I mean, she'd get a treble hook stuck, and get her two fingers hooked together. And
no, that was
and
my I'm, mother.
Say, oh, my, I know, but you come from that stock. And she's like, "Bring me some pliers. I'll get it out of there." I'm like, "Oh, sweet God, I'm about to pass out." You know? All right, so we're going to play this for you here. This is our first number one.
When a single mom goes out on a date with somebody new, it always winds up feeling more like a job interview. My mama used to wonder if she'd ever meet someone who wouldn't find out about me and then turn around and run. I met the man I call my dad when I was 5 years old. He took my mom out to a movie, and for once I got to go. A few months later, I remember lying there in bed. I overheard him pop the question, and I prayed that she'd say yes. And then, all of a sudden, oh, it seemed so strange to me how we went from something's missing to a family. Looking back, all I can say about all the things he did for me. As I hope I'm at least half the dad that he didn't have to be. Met the girl who's now my wife about 3 years ago. We had the perfect marriage, but we wanted something more. Now here I stand surrounded by our family and friends, crowded round the nursery window as they bring the baby in. And now all of a sudden, all it seems so strange to me how we've gone from something's missing to a family. Looking through the glass, I think about the man standing next to me.
Hear it for Kelley and Clint, Karen.
Thank you. Clint, thank you, Kelley.
Give it over, Karen. Thank you.
Oh, we got a thank new you. Number here.
Oh, right. it's working already. $1,625 on text to give. Great job, Karen. Great job. She's got an Airbnb we're going to auction off here in a little bit, and so make sure you're paying attention to that as well. And Thanks for helping us sing on that and play too, Mo. That's awesome.
I love that song.
That's awesome.
I told him that's one of them songs when I was young and sitting in the back seat, and I probably shouldn't be telling you this, but
no, go on.
My dad driving me around, and that song, he bought that record, and I just sat back there and cried listening to that song the first time I hear it.
Wow.
That's part of the reason why I'm sitting up here today is because I heard songs like that back then.
Thank you very much.
This is a brand new song I wrote for my wife with Will Nance and Paul Overstreet a couple weeks ago. I think that this will probably make the next record, so hopefully the record makes it out someday. You've been doing this thing for a while now. Had our share of crazy ups and downs now. It's good to see we're still around now, ain't it, babe? Life has a way of drifting hearts apart now, but we just keep on keeping that spark now. If love can make it through the dark now, we found a way. 'Cause I still wanna kiss you in a crowd now, sing my love songs out loud now, let everyone that I know now know I wrote about you. Guess all I'm trying to say now, girl, I don't want to miss a day now. And there ain't nothing like right now with you. Girl, you're sure looking good now. If you'd let me hold you, I would now. And touch you just like I should now, my fingertips. Got something running through my head now, wanna sleep over on your side of the bed now. I've got sweet words that I haven't said now on my lips, and I still wanna kiss you in a crowd now, sing my love songs out loud now, let everyone that I know now know I wrote them about you. We may not have yesterday now, tomorrow's too far away now, just let me spend all my right. Guess all I'm trying to say now, girl, I don't want to miss a day now, and there ain't nothing like right now with you. We've been doing this thing for a while now, ain't it good to see we're still around.
Yeah.
That's great.
Thank you. Woo! Thank you. Awesome, dude.
Let's review, shall we? So far this evening, we have learned that songs come from bad audiobooks, real life. The idea for this song came from the produce section of the morning paper. Vidalia onions were on sale at the grocery store. And so I got to thinking, what if instead of an onion, a Vidalia was a girl? Now, I will tell you all, a big part of successful songwriting is about problem solving. The first problem I had to solve here was, why would any young couple in their right mind named their baby daughter after an onion. So I got to thinking, well, maybe her dad is an onion farmer. And then I thought, I should probably think some more. And I got to thinking, being from the South, and I know from the South, on occasion, when it's the firstborn child, the couple will name the baby a combination of their two names. So I thought, I'm trying to get to Vidalia, so I'm thinking, well, if her mama's name was Violet, and her daddy's name was Dale, yes, once again, proving how sharp you are. Yes. Vidalia. Problem solved. Big hit. Bushels of money. It's just that easy.
Short-term memory's pretty good, too.
There ain't nothing so precious as a firstborn child. What to call their little angel, they wondered for a while. Your dear mama Violet, your proud daddy Dale, I know when they named you, they surely meant well. But Vidalia, Vidalia, girl, won't you tell me why? Sweet Vidalia, you've always got to make me cry. I never paid no attention to the girls before, till the day I saw you standing in the Sunday school door. One boy sort of snickered when the roll was read, till you laid the word of God upside of his head. Vidalia, Vidalia, hey girl, won't you tell me why? Sweet Vidalia, you've always got to make me cry when I try to get too close. Seems like we've always been almost just one step or two away from true love. Yep. I love the way you talk. I love the way you kiss. I love to get away with you alone like this. If I could just mention just one little thing, Vidalia, would you stop living up to your name? Vidalia, Vidalia, hey girl, won't you tell me why? Sweet Vidalia, you've always gotta make me cry. Hey Vidalia, girl, won't you tell me why? Sweet Vidalia, you've always gotta make me cry. You've always gotta make me cry. You've always gotta make me cry.
Song about an onion, Vidalia.
Tim Nichols.
Thank you, thank you.
Love that. Everybody does know that Mitch is from here, right? So where were you raised primarily?
Oh, where wasn't I raised?
Everywhere?
Yeah, all over. All over. My grandparents live in East Brainerd. They lived there for a long time. So I was there a lot. And a little bit of Hickson, a little bit of Signal Mountain.
Go Wildcats.
Yeah. A little bit of Ootawall, a little bit of, yeah. I got all of it. Yeah.
That's awesome. Well, I'm so glad to just have a new friendship with Mitch, and we were actually going to play golf this morning on the way up at the honors. We were talking to our host, you know, Evan. Mitch called me last night at like 9 o'clock, and he said, man, did you check the forecast for tomorrow? And I said, no. I mean, I say one day at a time. It's actually, I probably live 12 hours at a time. But he goes, man, it's 100%, you know, rain. And I said, really? And I got disappointed. And he goes, yeah. He goes, and we're starting to think, well, we got to get up at 4:45 to go play golf, and so we were
which is worth it.
It's worth it
unless, if you can play.
Yeah, if you play. You know, so anyway, we decided to sleep in just a little bit, but it sounded like it was a good idea. Didn't it rain here like 2-3 inches a day, something like that? Don't you love Tennessee, how it rains every day or it's cold? God, man.
Seriously.
Tell you what.
It's been so windy this year, too. I don't know what it is. I feel like we're in Kansas, in middle Tennessee. It's weird. All right. Let's get this train rolling. Everybody's feeling good, right? Everybody's good? All right. This is a song that I wrote with two buddies of mine, Dean Fields and April Jesbury, back in Nashville. And it's a song about when I was a little kid, my dad would come get me every other weekend, and we'd drive about 2 hours back to his house. And the whole way, all we did was listen to 90s country and classic rock in the car. And those songs became the fabric of my life. And it's amazing how powerful music is, man, where it takes you back every time you hear those songs, and the way it shapes your life. It gets you through hard times. It makes you laugh, makes you cry, all those things. And that's what this song is about. So I hope you guys dig it. I was 15 on a vinyl bench seat the first time daddy let me drive, grinding gears, but all I could hear was the King singing Blue Clear Sky. And then at 18 it was all Christine, she's in love with the boy was our son, cause her daddy, he didn't like me, I guess Tommy ain't the only one. Yeah, I learned life is a highway, so take it easy, cause it just don't happen twice. Walk the line, love like crazy, and live like you would die. Every day is a winding road, ain't no doubt I was raised by the radio. Out there raised by the radio? Yeah. Yeah, and at 21, I was born to run, and AC/DC had me back in black. Well, I was raised in hell, and then I lost myself, and much too young brought me back. Yeah, and at 26, I met Jesus, found a love without end, amen. But I still wind up down in real low places where I find all my rowdy friends. And I learned life is a highway, so take it easy, cause it just don't happen twice. Walk the line, meet in the middle, and live like you die. Every day is a winding road, ain't no doubt I was raised by the radio. I've been cranking up that dial as long as I can remember. These songs have raised my glass, saved my life, even helped me get lucky a few times. I believe nothing reminds you who you are like hearing a song that reminds you where you've been. So think back to the songs that define your life. As for me,
life is a highway, so take it easy, cause it just don't happen twice. Walk the line, love like crazy, and live like you are dying. Give me the beat, boys, and free my soul. Ain't no doubt I was raised by the radio. Life's a dance, you learn as you go, y'all raise. You were raised by the radio. Yeah, I was raised by the radio.
Yeah.
Yeah, Mitch Rosell. Right. Love that.
Thank you. Appreciate that, y'all.
That makes you feel good right there. So I should play something depressing to counteract
yeah,
it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. No, that's great. Well, a lot of you guys that have been here before, you guys remember Neil Thrasher? Been here. His contract just, you know, required that he take a break this year. But no, I'm just kind of kidding. We just thought it'd be kind of good to keep you guessing a little bit, bring some new friends into the fold of Bethel here, which is always great. And but I've got a song here I'm going to play that you haven't heard. And Neil and I wrote it with a good friend of ours, Bobby Pinson. It's actually on Jason Aldean's brand new CD. It's called Rearview Town. And it just came out, I think, last week, April 13th. Not that I'm kidding. It was exactly April 13th. I've had it on my calendar for 9 months. But anyway, so I'm going to try this. I've never played it before. So we'll see how it goes.
Wiped her footprints off the dash, tore up those sun-faded photographs, threw them in the wind, y'all can have her back. I'm out of here.
Yeah,
put my middle finger in the sky, flipped off that y'all come back sign, looked in the mirror one last time, watch it disappear. Cause it ain't nothing but a rear view town, broken hearts and rusted plows, roof tripped right up out of the ground, never thought I'd ever meet it. It ain't nothing but it used to be, population minus me, on the other side of that dust cloud.
That's huge. Applaud that. I'm kidding.
I could tough it out, but what's the use? In a place this small, it's hard to do. Too much of her to run into. Too many roads to somewhere new. It ain't nothing but a rear view town. Clouds, roots ripped right up out of the ground. Never thought I'd ever leave it. It ain't nothing but it used to be. Population minus me on the other side of that dust cloud. Ain't nothing but a rear view town. Nothing but a rear view town. It ain't nothing but a yesterday. One less truck rolling down Main. Ain't nothing left to say. But it ain't nothing but it used to be. Population minus me on the other side of that dust cloud.
Kelley Lovelace.
Thank you very much.
With the title track of the new Jason Aldean album, Rearview Town.
Thank you, Tim. And that brings us to our next thing. We have $12,819 in text to give. You guys are doing amazing. Keep it coming. Let's set a record. It's fun.
Well, I'm not saying this at all because I'm up here, but you guys are hearing some world-class music, and I'm honored to be on stage with these guys. It's the first time I've got to hear any of Mitch's music, and I know I've been bragging on him a lot even off the stage, but I haven't been blown away by a newer or younger. He he's probably older than me, I don't know, but artist in Nashville a long time. He's just blowing me away with his music. So give him a hand.
Thank you, Bo. I really appreciate that, man.
These other guys are just okay.
We're old. We're old. We've been around a long time. We're really old.
No, this is, I'm fans, huge fans. It's important that we, I think relationships, I know relationships are important to God, and I think that's why he made music, and that's why he made kitchen tables, and that's why he made pickup trucks, maybe, I don't know. You sit close to each other driving down the road, or... but it's especially important, I think, that those relationships go well, especially when we're young and the people God chooses to put around us. Sadly, that's not the case for everyone, and I know we've all seen the negative side of relationships. Talking to a lot of guys my age and older, there seems to be one relationship in particular that... seems to be most important, and if that relationship goes bad, it heightens your risk for everything else to go bad. I was talking with my buddy Bobby Tomlin about this for about 2 or 3 hours, and by the time we were done, we came up with this song, and it's probably going to make the next record, and it's something that's really personal to me, and I just thought I'd share it with you guys. You open up your eyes. He's holding you for the first time. Somehow you just know it's gonna be okay. This is new to him too. He don't know what he's doing, but he knows he's gonna do whatever it takes. Oh, and you're gonna need him. You're gonna find out you'll try hard to please him, but you'll hurt him with stupid things you do. God have mercy on the drunks in the alleys, little boys in their daddy. You know he's gonna be your hero. You'll miss him all day long. You're gonna run and tell mama daddy's home. But then you'll get a little older and think you know what you're talking about. When you stand up and tell him, I can't wait to move out. Oh, but you're gonna need him. You're gonna find out he needs you too. You'll still try hard to please him, but there's gonna be things you God have mercy on the homeless in the alleys and little boys and their daddies. Little boy, little boys, don't stay little boys. You're gonna have a little boy like you. The way you treat him right or wrong is gonna follow him along.
gonna see it in his little boy too. God have mercy on drug addicts in the alleys, little boys and their daddies.
Yeah, man.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. Woo. Yeah, man. Yes, sir.
That's good. That's real good.
So I wrote this song with Connie Harrington, Jamie Lynn Spears, Britney Spears' little sister. And it's been several years ago. I don't know, probably 6 years ago now. And when we wrote it, it was basically Jamie Lynn's story. And so we write it, and it's like we really like it. We're all fired up about it, and we play it for her management team there. We wrote it at her office, and they're just like jumping up and down. And they said, "Hey, look, you don't even have to demo this song. This is 100% going to be on Jamie Lynn's record. 100% going to be on Jamie Lynn's record." So for those of you that don't speak music business, this is 100% going to be on Jamie Lynn's record. Translates into, there's not a chance in the world this song is going to be on Jamie Lynn's record. That's the music business translation into the real world English. And so we didn't demo the song. We didn't do anything with it. And so I would check in every so often, you know, every 18 months or so. Do we need to do anything with the song? No, we love it. 100% it's going to be on the record. Like 4 years go by. And Jamie Lynn's record comes out. Well, I run to iTunes, and I get on the computer, and I start at one. Down to about 15, I think. Not on the record. Nope. This is 100% not going to be on Jamie Lynn's record. So we had never even demoed the song. So we go in and demo the song, and the very first pitch, the very first artist that we played it for heard it and loved it. And come to find out, she had even been trying to write this song because it was her story. And so I think what it goes to show you is that songs find their way. And they belong, they end up being where they're supposed to be. The day we wrote that song, we thought we were writing a Jamie Lynn Spears song, but we were really writing a Jana Kramer song called I Got the Boy.
I saw your picture in the paper, honeymoon in Jamaica. He's a lucky, she's a lucky girl. She got you.
Okay. You can see it was important to all of us that tonight's show not come off too slick or too polished. You can see we got nothing to worry about.
I saw your picture in the paper, honeymoon in Jamaica. She's a lucky girl. You look so grown up in your black tux from a ball cap and a pickup. Seems like another world. You and me and our big dreams falling in love. We were two kids in the backseat, all fearless and young. I got the first kiss, she'll get the last. She's got the future, and I've got the past. I got the class ring, she got the diamond and wedding band. I got the boy,
she got the man. Now there's the old you that I knew, fake IDs to get into those spring break bars, and backwoods on the four wheel, holding on tight. I can still feel my racing heart. Now you're cleaned up with a haircut, nice tie and shoes. If things were different and I had a choice, which would I choose? I got the first kiss, she'll get the last. She's got the future, and I've got the past. I got the class ring, she got the diamond and wedding band. I got the boy, she got the man. I got the first kiss, she'll get the last. We both got something the other will never have. I got the long hair, the hot head, she got the cool and steady hand. I got the boy, she got the man. I got the boy. Robin Kane got the man.
Thank you so much.
Tim Nichols.
Thank you, thank you.
That's right. Great song. That's a big old hit. Big old hit.
Amen.
Hey, you guys got time? Can we go around another time? Is that all right? I don't know what time it is. Let's do
it. Cool. Well, it was an honor to be here tonight with you guys. Honored to share the stage with all these guys. I don't feel like I deserve to be up here, but I'm honored to be up here. And so much talent up here. Mo, you have literally the purest voice I've ever heard in my life. Am I right?
Awesome.
Good gracious. I feel like a girl in the front row. He's singing, and I'm just going. You know,
I'm sorry to hear that.
So he's like, now that makes sense why he's been so close to me backstage.
Thank you.
But I know it's an honor to be up here. I'm gonna play you guys a song. It's definitely the most personal thing I've ever written. I was telling you on the last song that my dad would come get me every other weekend when I was a kid, and we were really close growing up, and I unfortunately lost him at a young age, and he's the reason I'm playing this guitar in the first place. When I graduated high school, I went and bought a guitar one day because he always wanted me to play, and I never would. I was a sports kid, and that's, I just didn't have time to pick up a guitar. You know, I was busy doing other things, but I picked one up to honor him. Had no intentions to do anything with it. Just wanted to play. And fell in love with it. And became afflicted with a songwriting bug, I guess. And so I wouldn't be sitting here without him for many reasons. But I guess I've been writing songs for, golly, over 10 years now, which is crazy. But I'd never really written anything about my dad, which was kind of crazy because we were so close. And people would ask me all the time, you know, have you ever written a song about your dad? And I kind of didn't know how to answer it because I was like, no, and that sounds bad. But 2 years ago, April 17th, would have made he was 2 years old. I had a little boy of my own. And completely changed my life in every way. And it also, I think that there was a hole in my heart for so many years from, you know, my dad being gone. And it's like my son came in and filled it up and made a bigger heart almost, you know, just the love that I feel is beyond anything I've ever felt in my life. And I think that it healed me. And it made me able to access that place. And I finally wrote about it and sat down with my buddy Dave Turnbull and we wrote this song, and it's my life. I hope you like it. Mom was always running, chasing after something. I heard you couldn't tell her nothing when she was 19. Well, she met my daddy and took off in his T-top Chevy. But it went from hot to heavy when they found out about me. Every other weekend was all I got to see. Sometimes he'd come get me and we'd hit Tellico Creek. We'd take that boat and drop it, grab the rods and reels and hop in. He'd open up that tackle box and he'd open up to me. And he'd say, son, I hope you know how much I love you. And when you're not with me, I'm always thinking of you. You're the drive inside my heart, the reason I reach for the stars above. He said my world revolves around you, and that's why I call you son. Drive back to a small apartment. It was Hot Wheels on the worn-out carpet. We'd play games till the Braves game started, and he'd let me stay up late. Time with him was always flying. Sundays never had good time. I'd start to pack and end up crying, and he'd kneel down and say, son, I hope you know how much I love you. And when you're not with me, I'm always thinking of you. You're the drive inside my heart, the reason I reach for the stars above. He said my world revolves around you, and that's why I call you son. I was gonna go live with him, but I guess God had other plans. Cause on a two-lane road on a Tuesday night, a drunk driver crossed that center line. They said my dad didn't feel a thing. Well, I wish I could say the same. Cause losing him, it left me cold. I was mad at God, couldn't let it go. And then one blue sky morning, a brown-eyed baby boy was born. And I looked outside and it started pouring. I swear they were daddy's tears. My old man, I could almost see him. And that little face with a new heart beating. And the pain in mine started leaving when I whispered in his ear, son, I hope you know how much I love you. Now it all makes sense, this place in life I've come to. You fill the hole inside my heart. You're why I'll reach for the stars above. My world revolves around you. That's why I call you son. That's why I call you son.
Ooh, that's strong, brother.
Thank you.
So good, buddy. So good.
How about that?
Wow.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Wow. Appreciate that, y'all. Thank you.
So I too am going to play a moving ballad about my father, because this is a competition. I'm kidding. I would never play a ballad after that ever. Let's change it. I'm going to play something funny. That's really amazing. That kills me. That's great. Just so thankful. You know, I'll go down the line real quick and just again thanking US 101 for Ken and Daniel and Justin and Kelley and everybody just giving so much love and support and heart to Bethel. Just very thankful to them. Very thankful for Bethel. Just as an organization, just the house parents and the people that gift and tithe their lives to the kids at Bethel, I think is awesome. To you people, to giving your time and your money. Yes, we're having a fun tonight. We're also raising money for an incredibly important thing, which is those kids. And it's just amazing. And also extremely thankful, obviously, to God for blessing this. I was so scared when we started this a few years ago. I thought, what if nobody comes? How embarrassing that'll be. We had no money for Bethel. Nobody will come. And I think we started out our first year maybe 200-300 people, and now it's grown to this, and that's because of all you people and just the word of mouth, and we love you very much, and thank you so much for just being here. And with Mitch Rossell, just I'm glad to have a new friendship with him, which is going to carry on, and so thankful that he's from here and wanting to get involved with Bethel. Just the fact that you're here is amazing, and how talented you are. Look forward to riding with you, working with you, playing golf with you, and everything, sharing life with you. So it's just Amen. Awesome. So
thanks for having me.
Absolutely. And then Mo Pitney, I'm so glad that I got a chance to hear you, because like you guys are hearing Mo maybe for the first time, and I am too. So we're up here kind of working, but we're really just enjoying the show too. That's what we're doing. But just a huge hand for Mo also, take his time out to come here. Incredibly gifted singer and songwriter. Both these guys are. But probably my favorite singer tonight, is Tim.
Well, thanks, Pat.
You know, because I felt
right back at you. Yeah. I feel the same way about you. Exactly.
Thank you. Yeah, it was kind of like when Mitch was, looking past me, like to get us to compliment Mo and how great a singer he is. That's kind of like looking over to, at the girl across. Hey, excuse me, ma'am. Hey, you're beautiful. You're so beautiful over there. No, not you. Not you. But you. You look amazing. So anyway, Tim's my favorite, but these guys are great too.
Right. That's exactly how I feel about you too, Kelley. I mean, you just have there's just a thing in your voice, man, that you just can't, you don't hear every day.
Well, thanks.
And so it's just,
you're right about
it's
amazing.
That.
You're totally right. No, thank you. So I'm gonna end with something funny here. And this is a song I did write with Brad Paisley and ultimately, but I started out writing it with a good friend of mine. And so for 6 months we had nothing. And so I say 6 months. What I mean is technically it's every other Tuesday between 11 and 3. So if you boil it down, probably 2.5 weeks. Okay, so still is a long time to have nothing. But nonetheless, eventually I threw out the opening two lines of this song, and he said, "What's that?" And I said, "I don't know, but he'll record that." And he said, "What's the title?" I said, "I don't know, but he'll record that." And so we got it into shape enough to pitch it to him, and had a little bit of a working title, and pitched it to him that night. He ended up really liking it. We stayed up over at my place. It was about 4:30 in the morning. We finished it, and when songwriters are in the room with an artist, and the artist is laughing, high-fiving you, and just loving it, then you're thinking, we can stay in our house for another year. That's kind of what we're saying. But it's just a great moment just to impress somebody that you really appreciate their talent and everything. Well, anyway, so we were just excited about that. Then Brad gets a call, and he answers it, and he says, "Your water broke?" I looked at my co-writer, and I thought, man, this is a terrible time for a miracle child, So he says, "I'll be right over." And so he's kind of running down my office stairs, and I'm sheepishly following behind him. And he's going out there in the driveway, and I said, "Hey, you want me to just drive you over there?" And he goes, "No, I'm going to run." And his little white cowboy hat disappeared over the horizon. I just yelled out and said, "Do you still love the song?" "Oh." Crickets. I got nothing. So the next morning he calls and he says, "Hey, by the way, it's a false alarm, so everything's fine." I said, "Oh, thank God, because I stayed up all night praying and fasting for the child to be." And he said, "Yeah, whatever." And he said, "Also, I think we wrote a hit song last night." And I said, "Really? I didn't think much of it." So here we go.
"I
When you see a deer, you see Bambi.
Oh, yeah.
I see antlers up on the wall. You see a lake, you think picnics, and I see a largemouth up under that log. Well, I know you're thinking that you're gonna change me, and in a few ways, well, you might. Scrub me down, dress me up, all but no matter what, honey, I'm still a guy. You see a priceless French painting. I see a drunk, naked girl. You think that riding a wild bull sounds crazy? Well, I'd like to give it a whirl. You know love makes a man do some things he ain't proud of, and in a weak moment I might walk your sissy dog, hold your purse at the mall. But remember, I'm still a guy, and I'll pour out my heart, hold your hand in the car, write a love song that makes you cry, and then turn right around, knock some jerk to the ground, 'cause he copped a feel as you walk by. I can hear you now talking to your friends, saying, yeah, girls, he's come a long way from dragging his knuckles and carrying a club and building a fire in a cave. But when you say a back rub means only a back rub, then you swat my hand when I try. Say at the end of the day, honey, I'm still a guy, and I'll pour out my heart, hold your hand in the car, write a love song that makes you cry, and then turn right around, knock some jerk to the ground, 'cause he copped a feel as you walk. Well, these days there's dudes getting facials, manicured, waxed, and Botoxed, with deep spray on tans and creamy lotiony hands. You can't grip a tackle box. Yeah, with all of these men lining up to get neutered, it's hip now. Yeah, honey, I'm still a guy. Yeah, my eyebrows ain't plucked. There's a gun in my truck. Oh, thank God, I'm still a guy. Yeah, boy. All right, thank you very much. Y'all were fun. I appreciate it.
Well, just like you said you wouldn't play a slow ballad after his song, there's no way in heck I'm going to play a funny song after that one. Everybody just stare at me. I really don't know what to play. Alrighty, I'll play this just because a couple people asked me to play it.
This is one of the best songs that I've heard since I moved to Nashville. I'm not even joking. I love this song.
I was going to sing something just a little bit happier, like maybe find a happy medium or something, but I guess that's not going to happen. Thank you guys so much for having all of us here. This really is the easy part. Singing and playing is kind of comes like breathing. Something that does not often come like breathing to us humans is loving your neighbor. And for you guys who face it every day and go down there and give your time and pour out your heart into other people, you really deserve all the honor here tonight. And we're just kind of up here picking away. And so, but thank you so much for having us. You know what? Can I? I'll play that song backstage.
Yeah, yeah. Do something else. Do something else.
This song is a song I don't actually play out live often. I don't know that it'll make the record, but this seems like the right place to play it. I got to write this with Billy Montana, and it's one of my favorite songs I've been a part of. Songwriters, especially in country music, we love story songs. I know the listener does too. I think you guys like story songs, don't you? So we got together and we just figured we'd, well, first we started to talk about story songs and stories, and the best stories happen to be true. And so we figured that we'd write the greatest story ever told and the greatest story ever lived out, kind of in our own way, and this is what fell out. Once was a king, was the king of everything, who had everything he needed at his feet. But the people of the land were crying out with empty hands. They were thirsty, they were dying in the streets. He knew he and only he could be one to lead him home. So he faced winter chill. It's hard to believe he'd even step down off that throne, but he would go lower still. The first night away from home, you know he woke up in a barn, his royal body laying on the hay. It was a humble place to start. It was lonely, it was dark, and for the first time he had nothing to say. Pictures in his mind showed him the road that he'd go down, already wrapped in a dirty blanket on the ground. He would go lower still. He brought hope and healing, mercy and love, and they praised him as he went from town to town. Some followed closely and some followed far, and others only tried to shut him down. Before he traveled back, he had some supper with some friends in an upper room, just talking man to man. And then he got down on his knees, began to wash their feet, said, "This is something you do not yet understand." He broke apart some bread, raised his cup and gave a toast, said his blood would soon be spilled. And later in a garden it was dripping off his cussing, they were screaming, crucify him on the cross. They didn't know who they killed. You know, Satan thought he won,
when they laid him in that rock. But there was life lower still. Once was a king, he is the king of everything, who had everything he needed at his feet.
The song about humility.
Mo Pitney. I'd like to thank Kelley for having us up here. $13,444. Thanks, y'all. I know Kelley's been doing this for several years now, and it's and he's been bringing his buddies up here, and you all are looking at four very fortunate fellas, and we know it, and we don't take it for granted, and that we're able to thankfully make a living doing something that we love so much. And I think the reason Kelley does this, knowing him as I do, I think the reason that he's happy to do this is because he views it as his way of giving back. And the reason that we always say yes whenever he asks is because it's our way of giving back. And I think everybody that's here tonight, I think to a degree, we all view helping Bethel do the work that they do and be the amazing place that it is, we're all just giving back. And it feels pretty good, doesn't it? It feels good to give back. Thank you all. So the day my buddy Craig Wiseman and I wrote this song was just like any other day. We got together about the crack of 11. That's right. I have a t-shirt that says, "Music is the reason I get up every afternoon." That's right. We were just making small talk, having coffee. We hadn't got around to, "Hey, do you have any ideas or anything yet?" We were just making, making small talk. And I was telling Craig a story that I'd heard just the day before about a friend of ours who had had a health scare. And now, thankfully, it turned out to be just a mix-up at the lab, and the guy's fine today. But there were several days that he literally thought that he was dying. That reminded Craig of a story that he'd heard on NPR about a woman who'd been diagnosed with cancer. And she said while she had time, she wanted to go mountain climbing in the Rockies. And so we started talking about those two situations and about living and dying. And we started trying to come up with lines that had living and dying in what could possibly be the title of a song. And we were tossing out lines like dying to live, and Craig said, "Hey man, what about live like you were dying?" And I was like, "Dude, I love that. Let's write that." And so we got about halfway through it, and my son had football practice that afternoon, and I wanted to get to his practice, and so since we had started late, in a songwriter's mind, we thought it made perfect sense and would be totally cool if we made up for it and quit early. I know, right? So Craig called me back that evening. It was probably 10:30 that night, and I was in my little basement home office, and he said, "Man, I think this thing is really special." I said, "I do too." Now, the only thing that you all don't know is another quirky thing about songwriters is that most of the time we tend to think our latest song is our greatest song. And we want our latest, greatest songs to be recorded by the biggest stars in the business, by the Brad Paisleys and the Carrie Underwoods and the Kenny Chesneys and the, you name it, Blake Sheltons. That's all well and good, except about 99% of the time, the new guy doesn't like our song. So we finish it over the phone, and we know that Tim McGraw is starting to look for songs for a new project. Tim McGraw being at the top of the food chain, so to speak, that's the first place we went. And this was that about 1% when one of the biggest stars in the business
actually liked our latest, greatest song. And he said, I'm going to record this, and he did. And it was the title of the album, and it was the first single. It stayed at number one for 10 weeks. It won an ACM Award for Song of the Year, and it won a CMA Award for Song of the Year, and it even won a Grammy for Best Country Song. Now, I will tell you all, thank you so much. Thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you. I want to tell you all, winning a Grammy is very cool. Yes. And if you all ever get the opportunity to win a Grammy, you should totally do it, because it's awesome. At the same time, I will tell you there are cooler things than winning a Grammy. If you can write songs like all of these guys have played tonight, you start hearing back from people about your songs and what your songs mean to them. And through the years, Craig and I have heard a lot of stories about Live Like You Were Dying, and I think the one that has stuck with me the most was we heard from a woman, and she said, you know that line in your song that says, I gave forgiveness that I'd been denying? She said, the first time I heard that line, I hadn't spoken to my father in 15 years. I was young, and we had a big blow up, and I got mad, and I left, and I didn't call, and he didn't call, and we did not speak for 15 years. Until I heard that line in your song, I gave forgiveness that I'd been denying. And I heard that line, and I picked up the phone, and I called my dad for the first time in 15 years. And we have a relationship now. I gotta tell you, that's way cooler than winning a Grammy. He said I was in my early 40s with a lot of life before me when a moment came to stop me on a dime. He said I spent most of the next days looking at the x-ray, talking about the options, talking about sweet time, ask him when it sank in, this might really be the real end. How's it hit you when you get that kind of news? I said, man, what'd you do? He said, I went skydiving. I went Rocky Mountain climbing. I went 2.7 seconds on a bull named Fu Manchu. And I loved deeper and I spoke sweeter and I gave forgiveness I'd been denying. And he said, someday I hope you get the chance to live like you were dying. Amen to that. He said I was finally the husband that most of the time I wasn't. And I became a friend would like to have. And all of a sudden, going fishing, it wasn't such an imposition. And I went 3 times that year, I lost my dad. He said, I finally read the good book, and I took a good, long, hard look at what I'd do if I could do it all again. And then I went skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds on a bull named Fu Manchu, and I loved deeper and I spoke sweeter and I gave forgiveness I'd been denying. And he said, someday I hope you get the chance to live like you were dying. Like tomorrow was a gift, you've got eternity to think about what you do with it. What would I do with it? What did I do with it? Y'all know this song? I'd like for you to sing along with me, will you?
Here we go. Come on. Let me hear you.
I went sky.
Yeah.
Rocky Mountain climbing. I went 2.7 seconds. Sweet. On the bull named Fu Manchu. And I loved deeper and I spoke sweeter and I watched an eagle as it was flying. And he said, someday I hope you get the chance to live like you were dying. 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 Thank y'all so much.
Tim Nichols.
Mitch Rosell. Hey, Mo, we just.
Mo Pitney. 15,000 on the text to give. 15 even. Thank you, Gage. That's awesome.
Y'all give it up for Kelley Lovelace.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.
How about it for Bethel Bible Village? Thank y'all so much.
All right, thank you guys. Y'all be safe. Tim Nichols, Mo Pitney, Mitch Rosell, we had a great time. Thank y'all for giving.
Such a great time. Thank y'all.